Hey there, welcome to another episode of Coding with CodeCat. This is Ravi और आज के session में we are going to learn three different ways on how you can upload an image to the server. इस session में एक programming challenge भी है which is going to teach you a lot of things. Now as usual, जो भी code आज के session में use होगा वो already GitHub और Google Drive पे updated है and if you need the code, what you can do is you can check the video description, click on the link and download the code for you. Now as usual, if you like the work that I'm doing, if you're learning something from my videos, then I would request you to please support the channel by subscribing and sharing it with your iOS group. That being said, let's begin our today's session. In today's session, we are going to learn how you can upload an image to the server. And there are multiple ways of doing this. Number one is by using Base64, the second is by using a byte array, and the third is by using multipart form data way. And ये जो multipart form data है काफी familiar होना चाहिए क्योंकि जब भी आप Google पे search करोगे कि how I can upload an image to the server, तो होता क्या है कि जितने भी stack overflow या फिर जितने भी block के links हैं वो यही बताते हैं कि आप multipart form data use करो और image upload करो. लेकिन multipart form data use करने से पहले ये जानना बहुत जरूरी है कि ये है क्या, व्हाट इज मल्टीपार्ट फॉर्म डेटा. सो वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट मल्टीपार्ट फॉर्म डेटा इन दिस सेशन. सो नाउ लेट्स हैव अ लुक एट द स्वैगर डॉक्यूमेंटेशन. सो आई विल स्विच टू स्वैगर यूआई और यहाँ पे आप देख सकते हो कि मेरे पास तीन पोस्ट इमेज पोस्ट सर्विसेज हैं. वन इज अपलोड इमेज, द अदर इज अपलोड इमेज विद बाइट अरे एंड द थर्ड वन इज अपलोड इमेज मल्टीपार्ट फॉर्म. नाउ इफ आई क्लिक ऑन दिस, यहाँ पे आप देख सकते हो कि इसका जो कॉन्टेंट टाइप है दैट इज मल्टीपार्ट फॉर्म डेटा. इफ आई क्लिक ऑन दिस गाय, the content type is going to be application JSON and you can select from this list aap koi bhi content type pass kar sakte ho. We are going to use application/json and if I tap on this, yahan pe bhi jo content type hai we are going to use application/json over here. Aur ye jo content type hai ye post request mein bahut hi important role play karta hai because it tells the server ki jo data aa raha hai uska kaun sa type hai. And I've already explained this in my API series in the post API video, and if you have not seen that video I would request you to please click on the I button which is on the upper right hand side corner and you can check that video if you want to know more about content type and then you can get back over here. So let me switch back to the presentation. Now I assume कि आपको already पता है कि Base64 और byte array क्या है, and in case अगर आपको नहीं पता है तो please mention it in the comments so that मुझे पता चले और मैं इन topics के ऊपर भी video बनाऊँ. So let's have a look at a demo जहाँ पे हम लोग image upload करेंगे server पे by using Base64 and byte array. But before we look at our demo, let me show you कि जो भी हम लोग image upload करेंगे वो कहाँ पे save होगा. So this is my Azure container. So as you can see, I'm refreshing. यहाँ पे कुछ भी नहीं है फिलहाल, लेकिन जब भी हम लोग image upload करेंगे तो जो भी image हमने upload किया वो यहाँ पे दिखेगा. So that being said, let me switch to Xcode. और Xcode के I already have some code written, so let me just go ahead and run the application. So यहाँ पे as you can see, if I select image, तो gallery open होता है and I can select any particular image over here. And when I tap on upload image, तो होना क्या चाहिए कि जो भी image है which is this right now, it should be uploaded to the server and should be visible over here. So what I'm going to do is, let me stop it. सबसे पहले हम लोग क्या करेंगे, हम लोग कोड फ्लो देख लेंगे कि how are we going to code this. So I will switch to Chrome and over here what I'm going to do, let me present this. जैसे ही अपलोड इमेज बटन पे टैप होगा, what I'm going to do is I'm going to upload the image. मेरे पास एक इमेज मैनेजर है and this image manager what it is going to do is it is going to post that image to the server with the help of the HTTP utility. ये जो HTTP utility है, we have already created this utility in the API series. So what I'm going to do is मैं code को फिर से नहीं लिखूंगा, मैं वही utility फिर से use करूंगा हमारे इस demo के लिए भी. So let me switch back to Xcode and over here you can see I have some folders which is manager, common, models and utility. The utility is the HTTP utility which I was talking about, and as you can see the content type is application JSON जो हम लोग use करने वाले हैं. The models include the request and response model, and as you can see कि जो request model है it is attachment and file name. ये attachment और file name कहाँ से आया, if you switch back to your Swagger documentation you can see जो upload image है it has attachment and file name. जो upload image with byte array hai, it also has the same request parameters, and this upload image with multipart form also has the same input parameters. Now you can also see that this image request is inheriting from the encodable protocol, and let me switch to response. Now रेस्पॉन्स में हमारे पास सिर्फ एक ही प्रॉपर्टी है विच इज़ पाथ, यानी कि जैसे ही सर्वर इमेज स्टोर करेगा इट इज़ गोइंग टू रिटर्न अस ए लोकेशन एंड दैट लोकेशन विल बी स्टोर्ड इन दिस वेरिएबल एंड यू कैन सी दैट द इमेज रेस्पॉन्स इज इनहेरिटिंग फ्रॉम डिकोडेबल। अब एनकोडेबल से क्यों इनहेरिट कर रहा है रिक्वेस्ट और डिकोडेबल से क्यों इनहेरिट कर रहा है रेस्पॉन्स, दिस इज समथिंग अगेन दिस इज समथिंग विच आई हैव एक्सप्लेन इन द एपीआई सीरीज। सो इट इज़ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट कि आप सबसे पहले एपीआई सीरीज के वीडियोज देख लें एंड देन यू कैन देन प्रोबेबली दिस कोड इज गोइंग टू मेक मोर सेंस इफ यू आर new to the concept of encodable and decodable. So let me switch to common now. In common, I have a structure called as endpoint, jiske paas static fields hai, and you can see that this static fields are nothing but the post API endpoints. You can see upload image, you can see upload image with byte array and multipart form. Now coming to manager, I have an image manager with a function that is upload image. Aur yahan pe hum log kya karenge, hamara code likhenge to upload the image. Before we begin coding, let's say if you're new to the world of APIs, आपने कभी सर्वर से डेटा गेट नहीं किया या फिर सर्वर पे डेटा कभी पोस्ट नहीं किया है, तो what you can do is you can check out my API series जिसका लिंक मैंने वीडियो के डिस्क्रिप्शन में मेंशन किया हुआ है. You can check out those videos and then you can continue with this session. So let's begin coding for uploading the image to the server by using Base64. So what I would do is I would create the HTTP utility. This is the object of HTTP utility and now I would create a request that is going to be my image request. Jo do parameter accept karte hai, one is the attachment, the other is a file name. So I would say data. Agar aapko data ko base64 string mein encode karna hai, so you can use the inbuilt function for this, which is base64 encoded string. The file name can be, let's say, base64 example over here. अब क्योंकि ये पोस्ट रिक्वेस्ट है, मुझे इस रिक्वेस्ट को पोस्ट बॉडी में कन्वर्ट करना पड़ेगा, विच इज दैट इज मुझे इसे डेटा में कन्वर्ट करना पड़ेगा. सो व्हाट आई एम गोइंग टू डू इज आई एम गोइंग टू से पोस्ट बॉडी एंड दिस इज समथिंग विच यू हैव ऑलरेडी सीन द एपीआई सीरीज. सो आई वुड से जेसन एनकोड डॉट एनकोड एंड दैट इज गोइंग टू बी रिक्वेस्ट एंड सिंस वी आर यूजिंग ट्राई, व्हाट आई वुड लाइक टू डू इज आई वुड लाइक टू यूज डू ट्राई कैच. आई एम गोइंग टू कट दिस, आई एम गोइंग टू पेस्ट इट ओवर हियर एंड आई वुड से लेट एरर और यहाँ पे डीबग प्रिंट यूज कर लूंगा मैं टू प्रिंट इफ वी गेट एनी एरर. सो राइट नाउ आई एम गोइंग टू यूज द HTTP यूटिलिटी एंड आई वुड से आई वॉन्ट टू पोस्ट सम डेटा टू माई API. सो द वेरी फर्स्ट पैरामीटर इज द URL. लेट मी एड सम स्पेसेस ओवर हियर. सो द फर्स्ट पैरामीटर इज द URL. सो आई वुड से URL स्ट्रिंग एंड दैट इज गोइंग टू बी endpoints डॉट अपलोड इमेज. The second parameter is the request body, which we have just created, that is going to be the post body. The third parameter is the decodable protocol, jo image response hai, since it is inheriting from decodable, and I would say self. And then over here we are going, in the closure we are going to get the response. Aur yahan pe main kya karunga? Completion handler, I am going to send the response to the class which is calling this function. So right now we have completed the code for the image manager. As you can see, it is making use of the HTTP utility. We have created a post body with this request. Hum log base64 encoded string pass kar rahe hain as an attachment. And we are using the HTTP utility. So far so good. Right now, what we can do is we can move to the view over here. Aur yahan pe aap dekh sakte ho ki in the upload image button tab, what I'm doing is I'm having a check. Jahan pe main ye check kar raha hu ki jo image view hai, use image hai ya nahi. Aur agar use image hai, so what we can do is we can continue our code over here. So what I'll do is I'll say manager, and this manager is coming from here. Yahan pe aap dekh sakte ho ki mere paas ek private variable hai which is manager, which is an optional image manager, and in the view.did.load I am creating the object of image manager. So what I would do, I would say image manager dot upload image, and I would say self dot image view dot image dot, iske paas ek function hai, that is png data, and this png data, as you can see, it returns a optional data. So let me just enclose this and then I'll unwrap it. Over here what I would do is I would say response, aur yahan pe once you get the response, what you can do is you can show an alert saying that you have got the response, but I will only show the response if the response dot path is not empty. So over here what I'm going to do is I'm going to say let alert is equals to UI alert controller, or yahan pe You can set the title, I would say just image, and the message would be image uploaded successfully. The preferred style is going to be alert. I would say OK action is equals to UI alert action. The title is going to be OK. The style is going to be default. Or yahan pe mujhe koi action nahi chahiye, so I would just call it as nil. So right now what I'm going to do is I'm going to say alert.addAction, that is going to be OK action. Aur main kya karunga, ye jo alert hai, ise present karunga mere view pe. So I would say alert and the animated is true. And kyunki ye jo alert hai, this is a UI activity. So as a standard practice, it is always a good idea to do all the UI activities on the main thread. So I'm going to use dispatch queue, main, async, and I will cut this and I'll paste it over here. यहाँ पे what I'm doing is I am showing the activity indicator जैसे ही आप button पे tap करोगे. So let me copy this, because once you get the data, it is a good idea कि आप activity indicator को hide कर दो. Let me format the page. And right now the only thing that is pending is to run the application and see what we get. So let me just run this. I am going to select an image. That is going to be, let's say I'll go with this. And I'll say upload image. So over here you can see the alert pop-up has come. So I'm going to say OK. And right now what I'll do is I'll refresh this. Aur yahan pe aap dekh sakte ho ki yahan pe abhi ek nayi entry hai. So let me click this. Let me copy this. And let me go ahead and paste it. So over here you can see this is the same image jo hum logon ne simulator pe select kiya, and we have posted this image to the server by using the base64 strategy. Now the second example would be to upload an image by using a byte array strategy. So what we'll do in that case is we'll switch back to Xcode. Now let us say your API developer tells you ki jo image API hai wo base64 string accept nahi karti hai, wo it is going to accept now a byte array. So the one good thing about this is ki jo aapko aapka jo data hai, that is this, it is already a byte buffer, and a byte buffer means that it is a byte array. So in order to upload an image using byte array, all you have to do is go to the image manager. Aur yahan pe what we are going to do is sabse pehle jo image request hai, we are going to jump to the definition. Ye jo attachment hai, we are going to make it as data. And over here yahan pe jo hum logon ne base64 encoded string use kiya hai, ise hum nikal dete hain. And I would say this is going to be a let's call it byte array example. Aur yahan pe main endpoint change kar dunga. I would call it upload image with byte array. I'll save it, I'll stop it, and I'll run it. I will say select image and I'll say upload. So right now you can see the image is uploaded successfully. So let me go to Azure portal. Aur yahan pe aap dekh sakte ho ki we have another image which is byte array example. I'll click this. I'll copy it. So here you can see the image is successfully uploaded. So right now we have learned two techniques to upload an image to the server. One is by using the base64 string. The other is by using a byte array. Now let me switch back to our presentation. And right now what I'm going to do is I'm going to share some clean code tips. So let's say aapne image server pe upload kar diya, ya fir image ya video koi bhi cheez server pe, aap koi bhi media aapne server pe upload kar diya, and you want to fetch that back. So it is a very good idea ki aap aapke API developers ko bole ki wo image object ya fir media object return karne se acha hai uski ek URL return kar de. As you can see over here, this is the URL. The reason for that is jo media objects hota hai jaise ki image ya fir video, wo bahut huge hote hain. And if such huge data is being transferred from the server to your mobile devices, to hota kya hai ki it costs network bandwidth. And let us say aap bahut sari images table view pe dikha rahe ho, aur jo API developer hai wo aapko as a link nahi, but you know, like actual image object return kar rahe hain. So it might happen ki jab aap scroll kar rahe ho table mein, thoda sa glitch hai, ya fir aapke views pe image theek se load, you know, like it can take a lot of time for that image to load inside your image view. So it is a very good idea ki rather than returning the actual image object, you can just say that to your API developers ki they can return this particular link over here. Now let's have a look at the third way of uploading images to the server, which is multipart form data. Multipart form data is a content type just like your application JSON. Application JSON में हम लोग server को ये बोलते हैं कि जो data post हो रहा है, that is going to be of the type JSON. In the case of multipart form data, what we tell is जो post body है, it is going to have multiple portions and each portion is going to be separated by boundary. Now what I mean by that is, let us say ये आपका image request है. Now this image request consists of two properties. One is the attachment and the other is the file name. तो अगर मुझे मल्टीपार्ट फॉर्म डेटा यूज करना है टू अपलोड माई इमेज, इन दैट केस व्हाट आई नीड टू डू इज, सबसे पहले मुझे एक फॉर्मेट तैयार करना पड़ेगा एंड दैट फॉर्मेट इज कॉल्ड एज मल्टीपार्ट बाउंड्री फॉर्मेट. तो सबसे पहले क्या करते हैं, एक विजुअलाइजेशन कर लेते हैं बिफोर वी क्रिएट दिस स्ट्रिंग, हाउ दैट स्ट्रिंग लुक्स, सो दैट हमें एक हल्का सा आइडिया रहे कि यू नो लाइक वट वी आर कोडिंग. तो सबसे पहले आती है मेन बाउंड्री एंड दिस मेन बाउंड्री हैज़ टू बी यूनिक. देन कम्स कॉन्टेंट बाउंड्री कि यहाँ से हमारा जो कंटेंट है वो चालू होगा, यानी कि यू विल स्टार्ट एडिंग द वैल्यू, यू नो लाइक द वैल्यूज ऑफ दिस. लेकिन वैल्यू ऐड करने से पहले भी हमारे कंटेंट बाउंड्री को आपको बताना पड़ेगा कि ये जो वैल्यू है वो किसके लिए, यानी कि आपको एक की बनाना पड़ेगा यहाँ पे, जिस तरीके से आप डिक्शनरी में की वैल्यू पेयर का एक कॉम्बिनेशन होता है, तो उसी तरीके से मल्टीपार्ट फॉर्म डेटा में भी की वैल्यू पेयर का कॉम्बिनेशन होता है. तो इन ऑर्डर टू डिनोट दैट आई विल बी एडिंग अ की कॉल्ड अटैचमेंट, दिस इज द फॉर्मैट. सो अभी आपने की डिफाइन कर दिया. द सेकेंड थिंग टू डिफाइन इज दी वैल्यू. और एक बार आपने की और वैल्यू दोनों डिफाइन कर दिया, द बाउंड्री एंड्स. नाउ द सेकेंड इज द फाइल नेम. तो हम लोग सेम फॉर्मेट यहाँ पे रिपीट करेंगे, आई एम गोइंग टू डिफाइन द की एंड देन आई एम गोइंग टू डिफाइन द वैल्यू. एंड अभी कोई हमारे पास प्रॉपर्टी नहीं है, दिस मीन्स वी कैन एंड अवर मेन बाउंड्री. सो इट विल लुक समथिंग लाइक दिस. एंड इफ यू पे योर क्लोज अटेंशन, यहाँ पे आप देखोगे कि एंड यू नो लाइक जब बाउंड्री आप एंड करते हो तो यहाँ पे दो डैशेस हैं. And this entire string format is going to be part of our request body. So it is very important कि ये जो format है, ये जो structure हम बनाने जा रहे हैं, इसका एक visualization इसलिए ज़रूरी था because जब हम इसे code करेंगे तो you know like the syntaxes can be overwhelming. So इसलिए एक visual representation बहुत ही ज़्यादा important है before we start coding for this. So that being said, let's begin coding for uploading an image by using multipart form data. So let me switch to Xcode. So in order to post data by using multipart form data content type, HTTP utility के पास ऐसा कोई functionality नहीं है. तो सबसे पहले हमें एक function create करना पड़ेगा which handles multipart form data uploads. So I will switch to HTTP utility and I would say I'll create a new function over here which is function post API data with multipart form and I would just copy this entire thing. And I will paste it over here. And I will change this request body to request. And this is going to be image request. Now, I know that this hard coding a particular request is not the best way of doing things. And it is not generic. But here's what I want to do. I want to give this as a programming challenge. I want you to figure it out ki aap is function ko kis tarike se aur flexible aur generic banaoge. And you can send me your solution via email ya fir aap mujhe GitHub pe tag kar sakte ho. My GitHub ID is same as my email ID which is codecat15@gmail.com. Now that being said, let's begin our code. So let me create some space first. Okay. So sabse pehle what we are going to do is we are going to create the object of URL request. And I would say URL request is going to be the request URL. The second thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to create a variable for line break and we will use this in a minute. And I would say this HTTP request is of the type post, which is similar to what we have seen in our post APIs. And now what I would do is I would create a boundary, which again we will be using in a minute. So I would create some dashes and I would say this is going to be UUID dot UUID string. And now what I'm going to do is I'm going to say URL request dot add value. And this is going to be multipart form data. And the boundary is equals to the boundary that we have, and this is for the HTTP header field content type. सो जिस तरीके से पोस्ट एपीआई में यू हैव सीन कि जो एप्लीकेशन जेसन है वो ये बताता है सर्वर को कि जो पोस्ट रिक्वेस्ट का डेटा आ रहा है वो जेसन फॉर्मेट में है. दिस इज वेयर वी आर टेलिंग अवर सर्वर दैट कि जो पोस्ट रिक्वेस्ट में जो डेटा आ रहा है दैट इज गोइंग टू हैव मल्टीपल पार्ट्स एज यू कैन सी इन द इमेज ऑन द राइट हैंड साइड कॉर्नर. सो यहाँ पे वॉट वी हैव डिड इज वी हैव क्रिएटेड द मेन बाउंड्री. नाउ वॉट वी आर गोइंग टू डू इज वी आर गोइंग टू टेक केयर ऑफ द नेक्स्ट पार्ट दैट इज क्रिएटिंग द कॉन्टेंट बाउंड्री एंड यू नो लाइक विल स्टार्ट अपेंडिंग द डेटा टू इट. सो आई वुड से वार रिक्वेस्ट रिक्वेस्ट डेटा इज इक्वल्स टू डेटा एंड राइट नाउ वॉट आई एम गोइंग टू डू इज आई एम गोइंग टू से request data append and I would say this is going to be my content boundary. So I would create a boundary over here slash r slash n and I would say data oops and this is going to be UTF-8 encoding. Perfect. सो अभी मैं क्या करूँगा द नेक्स्ट स्टेज एज यू कैन सी इन द इमेज इज हम लोगों को यहाँ पे अभी एक की ऐड करना है एंड देर इज़ ए पर्टिकुलर फॉर्मैट फॉर एडिंग दैट की. सो आई वुड से अपेंड एंड आई वुड से कॉन्टेंट डिस्पोजिशन इज फॉर्म डेटा एंड द नेम is equals to attachment and I would say block this and now what I would do is I would say line break plus line break and this again yahan pe hum log same cheez copy paste karenge. I'll just paste it over here. एंड नाउ एज यू कैन सी इन द इमेज कि यहाँ पे हम लोगों ने की बना लिया है. द नेक्स्ट स्टेप इज टू एड द वैल्यू. सो आई वुड से रिक्वेस्ट डेटा अपेंड एंड दिस इज गोइंग टू बी योर रिक्वेस्ट डॉट अटैचमेंट एंड नाउ द सिमिलर केस विल बी डन फॉर फाइल नेम. सो लेट मी कॉपी दिस ओप्स लेट मी कॉपी दिस गाय एंड लेट मी पेस्ट इट ओवर हियर. सो यहाँ पे मैं क्या करूँगा कि I would say this is going to be file name and over here I would say the attachment is going to be file name. Perfect. So far so good. Everything looks okay. And oh, since this is a string, you have to convert it into a data. Okay. So abhi, as you can see in the image, hamare paas ek main boundary hai. वॉट वी हैव इज ए कॉन्टेंट बाउंड्री एंड देन हम लोगों ने अटैचमेंट का की बनाया. फिर उसके बाद हम लोगों ने अटैचमेंट का वैल्यू अपेंड किया एंड देन अगेन वी हैव अ कॉन्टेंट बाउंड्री एंड वी हैव द फाइल नेम एज अ की एंड देन वी हैव द फाइल नेम एज अ वैल्यू. सो मोस्टली अवर कोड इज मैचिंग द इमेज दैट वी हैव एंड द ओनली थिंग दैट इज पेंडिंग इज एंडिंग द मेन बाउंड्री. सो इन ऑर्डर टू डू दैट वट वी कैन डू इज आई वुड से रिक्वेस्ट डेटा एंड आई वुड से अपेंड and I would say this is going to be the string you know like the string boundary that we have and I would say this would be line break. Perfect. And kyunki ye string hai ye ek data nahi hai so this is the reason why we are saying that this string kindly append it as a data. सो राइट नाउ आई थिंक हम लोगों का जो कोड है वो एग्जैक्टली हमारे इमेज के साथ मैच हो रहा है एंड द ओनली थिंग दैट वी हैव टू डू राइट नाउ इज वी हैव टू स्पेसिफाई द कॉन्टेंट लेंथ. यानी कि हम लोगों को सर्वर को ये बताना पड़ेगा कि यू नो लाइक वॉट इज द लेंथ ऑफ द डेटा दैट वी आर सेंडिंग. सो आई वुड से यू आर एल रिक्वेस्ट डॉट एड वैल्यू एंड this is going to be क्योंकि आपका सारा का सारा डेटा जो है वो रिक्वेस्ट डेटा में ऐड हो रहा है. सो आई वुड से रिक्वेस्ट डेटा डॉट काउंट एंड देन दिस इज कॉन्टेंट लेंथ एंड राइट नाउ वॉट यू हैव टू डू इज लास्ट बट नॉट द लीस्ट you have to say that Jo URL requester, it is having an HTTP body, and that body is this guy. So I think we are almost done, and the only thing that is pending right now is, let me just go ahead and copy this. And over here, what I'm going to do is I'm going to paste this. So let me quickly just go through our code, because we have bahut zyada type kiya hua hai, and I have to make sure ki कोई स्पेलिंग मिस्टेक्स नहीं हुई है या फिर कोई स्पेस नहीं छूटा है या फिर मैंने जो लाइन ब्रेक के सिंटैक्स है उसमें कोई गलती नहीं की है, क्योंकि अगर ऐसी कोई गलती है तो डिस्पाइट ऑफ हैविंग एवरीथिंग आपका जो पोस्ट है वो फेल होगा एंड द डेटा विल नॉट मेक इट थ्रू द सर्वर. सो इट इज़ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टू मेक श्योर कि यहाँ पे आपसे गलती से कोई वाइट स्पेसेस नहीं छूटा है. एंड इसीलिए मैं चाहता हूँ कि ये जो आपने यहाँ पे जो फंक्शन बनाया मैंने, इसे आप एक फ्लेक्सिबल जेनरिक फंक्शन बनाओ, सो दैट एनी डेवलपर हु यूजेस दिस फंक्शन शुड हैव द फ्लेक्सिबिलिटी कि उसको इतना ज़्यादा कोड नहीं लिखना पड़े, प्लस कोई उससे वाइट स्पेसेस या फिर कोई स्पेलिंग मिस्टेक्स ना हो. Now, speaking of line breaks, as I was looking at this code, I observed ki maine kuch jagah pe line break miss kar diya. So let me quickly just go ahead and add that. So I would say over here, I want to add line break. And it is always a good idea to add some line breaks over here. So I would say I am going to add some line breaks. Rather than doing slash r slash n over here, what you can do is you can just add line breaks like this, and that should be okay. So I think I have everything right now, and let's say if agar kuch error aata hai to we'll resolve it. So right now what I'm going to do is I am going to jump into the image manager, aur yahan pe what I'm going to do is I'm going to change this file name, and I would call it multipart form upload example. And I would keep this as same. Aur yahan pe, I don't think so we need this code, but let me just quickly go ahead and use the HTTP utility. So I would say this is post API data, aur jo URL hai, I would say the URL is going to be of the type upload image multipart form. The request is this request over here. और क्योंकि ये रिक्वेस्ट और रिक्वेस्ट दोनों का सेम नेम है, सो आई वुड कॉल इट इमेज अपलोड रिक्वेस्ट टू बी प्रिसाइज. द रिजल्ट टाइप इज गोइंग टू बी द सेम, दैट इज गोइंग टू बी द इमेज रिस्पॉन्स डॉट सेल्फ, एंड आई वुड से रिस्पॉन्स, एंड देन आई वुड से कंप्लीशन हैंडलर रिस्पॉन्स. एंड फॉर नाउ व्हाट आई विल डू इज आई विल जस्ट कॉमेंट दिस कोड आउट. And I would add some spaces so that we can see what's going on. Okay. So right now, I think we have everything, but there is just one last thing missing. Jo multipart form hai, jo image data accept karta hai, it accepts in base64. So we need to change the attachment, aur ise pehle ki tarah karna padega, which is of string type, jo hum logon ne base64 mein example dekha tha. Usi format mein ise convert karna padega. And now, what you have to do is you have to use the base64 encoding string, and that's it. So let me just go ahead and run the application and see what we get. We get an error. Perfect. So let's see. So yahan pe pehle jo ye append kar raha tha, ye jo attachment tha, ye data tha, ab ye string ho gaya. So what we have to do in this case is we have to say that this is data, and this is UTF-8, and I will save this, and I think right now we should be good. So let me just go ahead and run this. So let me select an image, and I'm going to select this Xcode image over here, and I'll say upload image, and you can see the image is uploaded. And now let me switch to Chrome and let me do a refresh, and now you can see there is a new image over here. And let me click this, let me copy this, and you can see this is the image that we uploaded. So far what we have learned is we have learned three different ways of uploading images to the server by using URL session. Number one is Base64, number two is by using a byte array, and number three is by using multipart form data. So in the case of multipart form data, what we have done is we have created a string format, lekin wo string format dikhta kaisa hai, wo humne nahi dekha hai. So let me just go ahead and show it to you. So I would say let str is equals to, I would say string decoding, and this is going to be the request data. And I would say this is going to be of the type utf8.self. So let me stop this. Let me add a breakpoint over here and let me run this guy. And let's see what we get. I will select the image. I will upload the image. And right now, if I can do this right, I will open it with a text edit. Or yahan pe, let me copy this and open it in VS Code. Okay. Alt-C. So yahan pe aap dekh sakte ho, as you can compare it with the image on the right hand side. This is your content boundary. This is the key that we created, which is the attachment. And this is the attachment value. Or yahan pe, as you can see, since this is base64, it is way too big. And let me quickly scroll this. Yes. So yahan pe aap dekh sakte ho ki ek aur content boundary hum log create kar rahe hain, and that is again a new key that is being created, which is file name. And over here you can see this is the file value, and over here you can see this is the end of main boundary. Now you may ask, where is the main boundary? So let me switch back to Xcode. Let me stop this. So yahan pe where we have written the where we have added the value as multipart, so this is our main boundary. Now with regards to programming challenge, what I want you to do is, rather than using this particular service for uploading the image, I have created a service for you for this challenge, that is the multipart code challenge. Or yahan pe aap dekh sakte ho ki jo content type hai, that is multipart form data, and this service is accepting 7 parameters. So in the case of image you had 2, but in the case of the multipart code challenge service, you have 7 parameters. Aur main chahta hu ki agar aap ye code improve kar rahe ho jo aaj hum log ne kiya hai, rather than using the image upload service, what you can do is you can use the multipart code challenge service, and you can email me your code or you can tag me on GitHub. Now yahan pe aaj ke session mein hum log ne ye sikha ki kis tarike se hum log image upload kar sakte hain server pe, and we just came across 3 different ways. Now kabhi bhi agar koi ek cheez hum log multiple tarike se karte hain, to ek comparison ka sense develop hota hai ki you know jo tarika main use kar raha hu kya wo sahi hai, kya wo optimized tarika hai. So I think you should be asking your API developers ki image upload karne ke liye aap byte array kyun use kar rahe ho, aap multipart kyun nahi use kar rahe, ya fir aap multipart kyun use kar rahe ho, aap base64 kyun use nahi kar rahe, and you should hear the technical reasons given by them. Maybe they'll give you a technical reason, or maybe they'll just say it is personal preference, but I'm pretty sure you'll find out. And once you find out, then do mention the answers given by the API developers, because I'm quite excited to know.
I really hope you enjoyed this session. If you like this video, then please give a thumbs up. And if you're new to the channel, then please subscribe. That being said, thank you so much for watching this. Have a nice day and happy iCoding. Bye-bye.